Time to bring the bass back. Mix is the beat of our culture. Our stories.
So I see myself having a couple number ones, number one albums.
Spotlighting inspiring content from Generation Mix. The next generation of creators, artists, and filmmakers. Our music. Discover fresh artists first from around the world. Uniquely Filipino.
It's hard to get this energy anywhere else.
Mix is the beat of our culture.
All right, hey guys, Dannieboi here from Manila's Wave 89.1 and Mix Global on Twitch and Kumu. With me, I got the very talented artist whose music has been trending lately here in the Philippines, so it's only right that we sit down and talk to him. Welcome, Pink Sweats. What's up, bro?
What's going on?
Hey, man, I'm chilling. How are you doing out there?
I'm blessed, man. Life is good. My family's, you know, alive, breathing. I'm healthy. I'm breathing. Can't complain.
Exactly, man. How you been doing during the pandemic? Where are you holding up at? Like, what part of the world are you in?
I'm in Los Angeles.
Okay.
And I'm having fun, man. I'm hitting a stride of, you know, I guess realizing that the pandemic wasn't going to be short, you know,
because
In the beginning, I'm sure for a lot of people, it's just like, oh my God. And like for me, I didn't leave the house for almost months.
Me too.
In the beginning. But, you know, I finally hit a mental peace, you know, where it's like, you know what, if this is how things are, I have to accept that. But I can't be down about it. Regardless of what happens, I can't allow outward influences to completely deteriorate my insides.
So exactly.
I found some peace and happiness in all of this.
Awesome, man. Now, of course, we're going to talk about your latest hit, At My Worst. But before we get into that, is it cool that we like kind of backtrack and get more info from you for the fans and also some fan questions on the way?
Yeah, all right. Let's do it.
All right. So I think you were really knocking doors down with your song Honesty in 2018, right? And what made you come out with that song in particular as your first single? And were you taken by surprise by how fast it gained attention?
Man, to answer the last question first, very surprised. and what made me choose it is just I always try to be different. I don't like to, or I guess I'm not trying to be different. I was allowing myself to be myself, if that makes sense.
Yeah, for
because,
sure.
Because, you know, the climate of music is so, it's so different from what previous generations had. You know, it's a lot of music. Just it's like have fun music. And for me, I like that kind of music. But I always had a soul where it's like I just want something more. Like I want to feel like when I'm listening to something, it really relates to my life. You know what I'm saying? Like I like listening to trap music, but I'm not trapping. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
so
right,
like,
right.
That don't relate to me. It's just fun to listen to. But when I wanted to listen to what I say, beautiful music that's like painting pictures of things that maybe I haven't even experienced, I felt like I wanted to be a voice for that. Where, you know, in today's world, it's not as common as like the 90s where you had like Boys to Men and you had a lot of diversity musically. Like now it's kind of like rap or die, you know what I'm saying?
True, definitely, man. And you know, it was well deserved, all the attention it gained. And we're gonna check out a little clip right here.
Love will happen when it wants. I know it hurts sometimes, but don't let it go. Cause
man, and you know what, I wanted to bring this up. You know, Filipinos are said to make the best covers. I don't know if you heard about that.
Yo, for real?
Yeah, have you seen some of the covers of Honesty?
I've seen a bunch.
Right, and there's this one from Russell Reyes, and I wanted you to check this out.
I told her thinking is all wrong. Love will happen when it wants. I know it hurts sometimes, but don't let it go. Cause I'm
Pink Sweats, man, your writing and vocal style is like so smooth. It's something that your fans here in the Philippines really identify with. We love sentimental songs. So just wondering, do you see and feel the love from your Filipino fans lately?
So strong. It's like you would think I was there. That's how much.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. They love your music, and your song has been charting here since it came out. So we're going to get into that in a bit. But moving a little bit forward from Honesty, one of my personal favorite songs of yours and videos was Body Eat Me. So
hey,
I'm going to be honest with you. When I first saw the visual, I was surprised because I heard the song first and then I seen the video. And I kind of like that contrast on how the song is very, very mellow and the video is kind of funny. So that contrast was dope. So what helped you, or what made you decide to approach that concept with a video that way?
To be honest, I really did it that way because, like, the song was so old to me by the time I did the video. Okay. So it was like, I didn't really want to do the video, but my label was like, you know, I think we should try a video. And I was like, okay. So I wanted to think of something that would make the process fun. You know what I mean? Okay. So I was like, creating a video that wasn't so serious and so spot on, you know, because like sometimes you'll do a video where it's like the video is exactly step by step with the song. So it's like, I don't need, like, you can see that in your head already.
Right.
I wanted to do something creative and fun, and also put like hidden little messages in there where it's like, I'm the kid in the video, but really, you know, like I liked older women when I was growing up. So I thought that was like a funny like thing where it's like, you're like, I'm not, obviously I wasn't a baby, but just exaggerating the imagery, you know?
I loved it, man. I love the video. So everybody watching right now, check this out. Little clip of Body Ain't Me by Pink Sweats.
Oh, I can't lie, I want you on me. Girl, I want to love you closely. I don't want nobody on you. If that body ain't me, body ain't me. I said I hate you, baby. I was trying to get through. I don't want nobody on you. If that body ain't me, body ain't me. Yeah.
And yo, man, I love that video so much. And now I think, or before COVID officially like affected everyone, you released 17, right? And what was that process like creating that track, and what were you hoping the fans take away from that song after hearing it for the first time, especially the first time?
Oh, wow. 17, I made that song like 4 years ago, and when I made it, it was like from a place of like grandeur, like something that I always wanted, where I was like, dang, like I've never been like madly in love with somebody at that time, and I never like really seeing a bunch of marriages. Like I never saw like a bunch of happy marriages. So I was like, dang, I want to make a song for people where they could listen to the song and outside of the number 17, like see themselves, where it's like, dang, when you fall in love, you're not trying to, you know, when you get married, oftentimes you're not getting married to just break up. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not right. Like, oh, I'm about to get married, me about to break up.
Yeah.
That's not normal. You know what I'm saying? Most people get married with the idea forever. And I just kind of wanted to create a song for those people who, like, you know what? I want to be with this person when it's unfavorable, not always when it's like, you know, we young and we hip. And also, I had like a funny idea where it's like, you know, you hear a lot of guys, especially guys, we do like, you know, like, I'm just living my life right now. Like, I'm just having fun. I'm doing me. So, like, in my head, I was like, that's crazy. So, you want to give your person that you love all your old dusty years while you done just did whatever you wanted when you was younger.
That's a good funny. That's a good way to look at it, man. So, everybody who hasn't seen the video yet, check this out. Little clip of 17.
You remind me that I'm still alive. So promise you never change, and I'll always be the same. We'll be dancing the same groove when we're 92, the same as 17. And I'll never lie to you, just don't you hold back on me. I wanna love you as strong when we're 92, the same as 17.
All right, so earlier you said that you like to make music that's a little different from like the current state of, or the landscape of, I guess, R&B, your genre or whatever. But one song that I really liked from you, what was a little different in my opinion, was when you did Icy, right? That came out not too long ago. A little more upbeat and dancey. And it kind of shows a different side to you, I guess. Can you talk about the choices you made in that video with the retro shots, the throwback vibe with that?
I went to the BET Awards and I had saw Morris Day perform.
Okay.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. It wasn't the BET. It was Soul Train Awards. Mm-hmm. I apologize. Soul Train Awards. And I saw Morris Day perform. And then I went on the internet after that, because they was just grooving. They was old heads, like, in there. I was like, yo, that's so dope. And then I went home, and I just started listening to a bunch of their music, and I was like, wow, like, I think I could create something like that, and nobody would expect it. And also, it's not really, like, to me, it's not really about songs being like, oh, a hit. This is a hit. This needs to be, like, for my team, like, obviously, they want that. But for me, it's like, I just want to create a story. Like, you know, if somebody finds my music, I want to create like an exciting story. Like, nobody wants to read a book that's like the same all the way through. You got highs, lows, and it's like, for me, I just want to create an overall story that when somebody finds my music, they think they know what Pink Sweats is, and then they come across that and they're like, oh, like, wait, he wrote and produced this too? He produced the other song? Wait, there's really no limits to this guy. Like,
exactly.
I want to stay on this journey. I want to stay on this story. Like, I want to keep reading. What's the next thing? You know what I'm saying? For me, that's how I look at it. I'm just too cold. I see. From my head to toe. They like me. I'm just too cold. Yeah. I see. Only way I know. Yeah.
For sure. If y'all just tuning in, I'm chilling with the one and only Pink Sweats. I got a few fan questions for you. From Jason, he's asking, who's an artist that you always listen to feel inspired?
Oh, an artist I listen to, Stevie Wonder. Love Stevie Wonder.
Awesome. Yeah. And Tina is asking, what was the last series that you finished watching completely?
The 100. It's called The 100 on Netflix.
Okay. Okay. And if you had one item in the world that you can have an unlimited supply of, what would it be?
Oh, wow. Is it got real or imaginary?
Yeah, either way.
Love.
Okay, perfect. And have you ever had Filipino food before? Someone's asking.
I haven't, but I need to. But I want to do it the authentic way. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to come there.
You got to come out here for that.
Get down. Yeah.
We're going to set that up. If ever you come out when everything's back to normal, we're going to make sure you get a proper Filipino meal. That would be so awesome, man. All right. So we have a Francis saying that his favorite song of yours is Lowe's. And he wants to know, was that song, did you make that song from like a personal experience?
I did. Oh, like all my songs come from personal experience.
Okay.
That one was just like my girl. It's like, dang. Like, you just... Like, even at my low, even when, and like, I feel like lyrically, it was like a little bit of a flip, because I feel like from a songwriter standpoint, like, typically I would have written, even at your lowest low, I'll always be there for you. But
right.
I wanted to paint a picture of like, doesn't matter, like, if I'm good, I'm always make sure you're good. You know what I'm saying?
Awesome, man. And because of this global situation, what are you missing the most out of everything else? From before,
I actually miss traveling. Like,
right.
I miss at leisure traveling, not like, cause like promo traveling, especially out of the States, is harsh. So I don't really miss that. Like, as far as like, if I would have had to come fly to you, and then fly to the next station in another country, then another day every day, I don't miss that part. But like, just the idea of being able to go, like, I'll be on Instagram sometimes. I'm like, see something dope, and it's like Greece or something. Like, just being able to be like, yo, babe, like, let's go to Greece. Like, stuff like that you can't do. And for me, I was just getting started. Like, I'm like, yo, I'm starting to travel.
Yeah.
I'm like taking my family places and stuff like that, just experiencing the world together, where it was like, dang, like, I miss that, you know, the feeling of meeting new people, hearing different languages, tasting different food. It's a beautiful thing.
For sure, man. And now let's put the focus on your new release, At My Worst. Can you give us a story or the background of the track itself, what it's about, and how you put it together?
At My Worst?
Yeah.
Man, it's funny because when I was creating that song, the first thing that popped in my head was...
Hey.
So I already had the bass line. I'm like, all right, cool. And then immediately I heard that top line in my head, and I was working on it with this guy. He's a producer too. His name's John Hill. And we were just like producing it, and I was like, all right, let me add the drums. I'm on the boots. And then he added the guitar over the bass line.
Mm-hmm.
And like when I walked in the booth, that was just the first thing that came up. It was like, can I call it?
Yo.
And I was like, oh, this feels good.
It feels good, man. When I first heard it, I felt good immediately. And you know that song, the melody is so infectious. It's been stuck in my head forever. So like, you know, I find myself humming it randomly. Like I'm just washing the dishes, I'm doing the laundry, whatever, I'm humming that song all the time. So it's amazing. And speaking
of it, makes
of
you feel happy, right?
It does immediately, right when the first chord comes in. And yes. You know, in the video you work at a laundromat. So my question for you is, have you ever had any odd jobs before you became a singer?
Man, you know what's crazy? They odd jobs to me, but maybe to like somebody else is not odd, but I've always tried to like stay in the vein of music. Like I used to be a drummer at a church.
Okay.
I used to work in an office. I used to actually help my dad clean up like churches and stuff. Like he would like go in and volunteer to clean up. So like when I was a kid, I used to do that. And then I used to work at Chick-fil-A. I don't know if you guys got Chick-fil-A out there.
We don't, but we know what it is. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, yeah, yeah. I used to work at Chick-fil-A.
Okay.
So to me, those are odd jobs because I always knew since I was a kid that I wanted to make music. So it's like, this is nothing related.
Yeah. Nice. And I love that video too. All your videos are dope, man. I've never seen a video or heard a song of yours that wasn't dope. And we really appreciate
you.
The Philippines really supports you and loves you. Like I said earlier, At My Worst has been charting since the week of its release. And, you know, anything you want to say to your fans out here in the Philippines and those watching around the globe right now?
Malakita, I appreciate y'all for real. Like, the love that y'all give me is very much appreciated. And I hope that I could come there and just, like, return that energy via a show or performance or sitting down with some people, eating some good food, whatever it is.
I got you.
I want to come out there and show mad love because it's real. I appreciate it.
Definitely, man. Like I said earlier, when everything's back to normal, we got to have you out here. We're going to feed you. We're going to sing all your songs along with you. You're going to feel the love even more in person. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, Pink Sweats, thank you for your time, bro. And best of luck to everything you do.
Thank you, man. Blessings.
For sure. God bless. Dannieboi signing out. Peace.
Peace.